Hello. I'm so thankful that you are his children. You have a good relationship with God, and he gives us grace. He has plenty of grace to give us. So what we need to do is obey and worship him and show how we have repented. Everyone needs to hear the gospel. We need to learn how to do things right and to give God the glory. Let's pray. Father, Father in heaven, we have a great relationship with you. You are our sovereign God. You have given us so many things. You poured out your blessings in abundance. And your beauty is just beyond unspeakable. We thank you for that. And we enjoy your presence. We turn to you. You are our priority. And your gospel is what we want to spread. So more and more people around the world will be your children. We pray now that these will not be my words, that this will be your words. And that your spirit will touch each person and give you the reward. And that we will depend on you for this word. And that your meaning will come out and give us joy. Everyone will learn to turn from their sins, that you have forgiven us of all of our sins. That's what you teach, that you are our daily bread. And that you have already conquered Satan, and we can depend on you. This is your church, and Jesus is our cornerstone. In Jesus' name, amen. I have a story to tell you from Luke. Chapter 4, verse 31 through 44. There are three parts to this story. So Jesus was in an area where there was a lake and water, and there was a town. He was preaching. He had preached all day. And the Pharisees told him that he could not do all of these things because their law said that he couldn't. But Jesus continued teaching regardless of what they said. He told God's truth, and people were watching him, that he had the authority. Now there was one person there. All the Jews were surrounding him, and just Jesus was teaching. But there was this one person who was demon-possessed. And he began screaming and shouting out and having seizures there. But Jesus looked at this person. And the demon spoke out of the man and asked Jesus, why is he bothering him? And he knew that he was the Holy One from God and giving God the glory. And that Jesus was the Holy One, the same person as God. But Jesus told him, the spirit, to be quiet. And commanded that demon to come out of that person. And the demon came out. But the person fell as he left. But he wasn't hurt. His body was strong. He was just like anyone else. And all the people were amazed. They looked at Jesus with amazement. They saw that that person was restored and that Jesus had the authority to command the demons. So that is the first part of the story. That Jesus had the authority to cast out demons. And even had the authority to quiet the demons. And Jesus had the authority and power to make him be quiet. Because he had come down from God. But Satan was talking about that. He didn't want the people to know yet that the Romans. So Jesus was in heaven and he had come down to the earth. But the Romans did not accepted the Lord. He wasn't there to destroy the Romans. He was there to forgive people. He was there to destroy sin. He was there to restore people's relationship with God. That was his whole point in coming. But the Jews didn't understand that. They thought that Jesus was coming to destroy the Romans, to free them from the Romans. So he told that demon to be quiet. It wasn't time for him to tell everyone about all of this. He didn't want to confuse everybody. So Jesus had the authority to cast out demons and quiet them. So Jesus left and was teaching the Jews again. Now he went to Peter's mother-in-law's house. And his mother-in-law was ill. And Jesus healed her, and she immediately got up and began serving and bringing water and taking care of the people in her home. And as the sun began to set, the Jewish people who were lame, crippled, and blind came to Jesus and asking for help and healing. They had heard he healed Peter's mother. But then the Pharisees' law said you could not do anything after sunset on Sabbath. So the Jews knew that. It was around 6 o'clock. So they all came and asked Jesus for healing. Then Jesus laid his hands on people to heal them. There were a lot of demon-possessed people, and he commanded the demons to come out of the person. He had that authority to quiet the demons. He's the Messiah. He was the Christ. And he could command Satan and the demons to stop doing whatever they're doing. So he had authority over the demons, but he also had authority to heal people. And the third part, it's very vital. It's actually the most important. Early in the morning, Jesus had left, and he went out to pray to his Father and commune with his Father. And all of the people came after him. He told them all to stay and not to leave. They all wanted Jesus to stay in that town. But he told them he had to go to the other town and preach the gospel as well. But other towns needed to hear what his Father had to say. He said that's why God sent him there, to restore relationship from people to God. So Jesus went to the other towns. He said that's why God sent him, to go to the various different towns, not just one. He taught the Jews, he taught the Pharisees, the Sadducees. So Jesus had the authority to cast out demons and heal people. And also to go to various different towns to spread the gospel. And really, has a lot more to say in the scriptures about it. But the last one has a little bit less to say, but that one is the most vital, the most important part, even though it's the smallest. Now this verse here, the disciples were there with Jesus, and they were going out two by two. He had told them to go out to various different towns to spread the gospel. And they went out in pairs. God was with them. Jesus told them that God was with them. And that God would empower them to heal others, to help people, and to cast out demons. He was to help people to cast out demons, to heal them, and also to do miracles. And that he could truly spread the gospel and to support them. And a lot of people were wanting to see the miracles and wanting to see people healed. And they were that much interested in the gospel. They wanted to see the power of God. They wanted to see people, the demons leave people. But God wanted them to repent and turn back to God, to leave their ways here on the earth, and to have a relationship with Him. That's what God wanted. That was His goal. Another story wasn't you know. There's a house. And Jesus was in the house teaching. And everyone went around the house, trying to crowd into the house and trying to get into the house. And Jesus continued teaching. And there were four people who were strong believers. They knew that Jesus could heal people. And they had a paralytic friend. And they were trying to get into the house to have Jesus heal them. But the door was locked. People blocked the door. They went up to the roof, and they opened the spot in the roof, and they lowered the man down right in front of Jesus. People thought Jesus could just command him, and he would be healed and walk out. The Pharisees were watching to see what Jesus would do. They were all watching. Jesus first told them, didn't tell them to heal to get up. He told them that his sins were forgiven. He didn't tell them that he was healed. He said, if you believe, your sins will be forgiven. So Jesus focused on his sin and that his belief would heal him. The Pharisees were appalled at that. They're saying that he is speaking against God. But Jesus doesn't have the authority to forgive sins. But Jesus did, because he is God. He came from God. God sent him. He said, if you truly believe in me, then you will be forgiven. But the Pharisees were just horrified about that. Jesus said, what was more important? That his sins were forgiven? Or that he was healed, and then he could get up and walk. He asked them, which one was more important? Well, Jesus has been healing people for many, many months at that point. But forgiving sins is only something God can do. Ever since Adam and Eve sinned, God has been working to reconcile man back to himself. At the temple, they worshipped in a temporary place of a tent, and they would sacrifice cows and calves. They would have to do it over and over again. But God still had a plan. Way before he sent Jesus, he had already planned that Jesus would die on the cross and that he would be buried and 3 days later raised. That was his plan because he cherishes all the people of the world. So that's why Jesus told the man that his sins were forgiven. And the Pharisees thought, why is he not telling the man to get up and walk? Jesus wanted them to know that he had the authority to forgive sins, that God had given them that authority. And he also had the authority to heal them, but that wasn't the priority. So he told the man to get up and take your mat and leave. So the man got up, took his mat, and he left. Yeah, he wanted to be healed, of course. But the better was that his sin was forgiven. So God believed his sin was still in him and not with him, and he'd come before God, he would be condemned. But now that his sins are forgiven, then he can go before God, and he's cleansed. And God can heal illnesses time and time again. But once He forgives us our sins, He grows His Spirit and His character in our hearts. Now this good part here, this helps me to remember that He cherishes us. That we are important to Him. So Jesus sends out all of His disciples in pairs, two by two. They went to various different towns. And then after they spread the gospel, they would come back together. And they would be so excited. And they would tell what happened in those towns and how many people came to know Christ. And they got to see God's power healing paralytic people, casting out demons in Jesus' name. And they were so excited. They just thought, wow, this is amazing. And they came back, they had to calm each other down. And so Jesus was here. He did all of these things. But Jesus is our God. He's authority over all of this. It shouldn't even surprise you, so why are you surprised? Jesus was there when Satan was against God. And God cast him out of heaven. And so you're excited that you were able to kill people in Jesus' name. But God cast Satan out of heaven. Restored their relationship. Because ever since Adam and Eve sinned, man's relationship has been torn from God. But in Jesus' name, it can be restored. That's what you should be excited about. That people have repented and turned to Jesus. That in Jesus' name, they will heal and forgive. That is what we should be all excited about. That our sins are forgiven. This is what this verse here talks about. Now, this is about the Pharisees right here. They were watching and observing Jesus. And they wanted proof that He was what He said He was, God's Son. They wanted miracles to prove it. Jesus said He had already proven that. That the world is full of sin and darkness. And that He didn't need to prove it. He had already proved it. He said the days of Jonah, the sign of Jonah, He's given them, He will give them back. Now you remember Jonah. God told him to go and spread the message to a town. And he refused to. He did not want to go to that town. So he decided to go on a boat, and then this giant fish swallowed him, and he stayed in that fish's belly for 3 days. And then later he did go to that town to spread the word. So that's a foreshadowing of Jesus, of dying and staying in the grave for 3 days. And then 3 days later, he goes, just like Jonah was in the giant fish belly for 3 days. And then was spit out 3 days later. Jesus was buried and laid in the tomb 3 days. And he said, that's the only miracle that you need. That's plenty. He wanted to focus on His death, the burial, and resurrection. There were many miracles and healings that He did all over the area. Or even people who died that He resurrected. And He forgave them their sin to restore their relationship with God. He said that was restoring relationship is much more important than the miracles. And the Pharisees wanted the proof. And Jesus told them that He already gave them the proof. Proof of Jonah. That He was going to die and be buried and be resurrected 3 days later. God loves you. He loves us. Jesus said that all over heaven and earth, that God has given to him. God has given him everything under heaven and earth. And everyone looked at him, thought he was very arrogant. They wanted him to heal people. And the disciples were there. He told them that he's had those many, many countries, millions of people. So I have taught you for 3.5 years, and they're all watching. But I want to send you out. I want you to go. I want you to make them my people, my disciples. I want you to restore their relationship to me. I want them to ask forgiveness of their sins, repent of their sins. That's a matter of who believes. If they believe in the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, they're baptized and believe in the Trinity, they will become His children. Even after they believe, they need to go out into other places and teach people, make disciples. They need to obey God and spread His word throughout the world. What God has given us, He's given us His love. He doesn't want us to keep it. He wants us to spread it to other people. So God has the authority to cast out demons. He has the authority to heal. He also has the authority to spread the gospel, which is more important. We don't want to forget God's plan of salvation and His forgiveness of sin and how He wants to restore a relationship. We should never forget that. That's the most vital part of this whole story. It's important that God can heal, but it's more important that Jesus died and was buried in 3 days later. And because He loves us, He cherishes us. And that is His plan. That's why God sent Jesus here to the earth. He wants us to be like Christ. He wants our heart and our desires to be like His. He wants all our desires to match His. He wants us to be the same. He wants our character to be the same. He doesn't want His character to change to ours. He doesn't want us to be like the world. We shouldn't ask God to come into us. We need to be Him. He's the one that we need to be like. We are under His authority. Well, I want you to think about this today, what God's Word said. Think about all the people who don't know Christ. They haven't read the Scriptures. You need to go and teach them the truth so that they will repent. And that God can heal them from healing their sicknesses. That's His plan. He can comfort hearts, He can reconcile hearts to Him. And we can give Him praise and thanks. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank You that You sent Jesus down here on the earth. I am cross to be buried and resurrected 3 days later. That if we believe in Him, that He will forgive us our sins, and that You want us to go to the different places. That is the most important, that we need to spread the gospel. The world is full of sin and darkness, and Satan was trying to draw people away into the world and away from You. There's so many people out there that we need to teach, Father. We need to teach them Your truth. We need to set up different churches all over the world. Every day we come here on Sundays and Wednesdays, every week we come and worship You. But there's so many missionaries out in the world. You love us. You take care of us. We are Your cherished children. And You want us to grow and develop and become more and more like Jesus. Father, we don't want to be more like You. We love You. We need to obey You. And we need to teach preach your word so more people will repent and restore their relationship with you. We love you, Father. We'll obey you. We don't want to have gather more things throughout the earth that will fade away and be destroyed. We want to focus on heavenly things, eternal things. Father, we know that we get busy here on the earth. Help us to focus more on you, your word. It's good to be busy, but that shouldn't be our priority. Spreading your word and your gospel should be our priority. And help our churches all over to be united together. Sometimes the truth causes people to go astray, but help our minds and our thoughts to be like you. Help us to be more like Christ, and not to expect you to come and be like us. But we don't want to be downcast. Then we can make things worse. And as we face you later, we'll realize we haven't obeyed you. So help us to obey you and try to be like Christ. Help us to restore relationships to you so that they will have eternal life. Thank you for the story that you help us. Help remind us that the gospel is Christ being dying and 3 days later raising from the dead. And that restores our relationship. He's like the foundation of everything. He's our blessing. He's our hope. He gives us our cool breath. He's like a cool breath. He takes care of the birds and everything in the world. He is the foundation. And he has found a way to destroy sin. Help us not to forget that and want things of the world. Thank you, Jesus. Help us to keep you as our priority. You are important. Thank you, God, for sending Jesus. And Jesus, thank you for sending the Holy Spirit in us to keep our minds clear.